in the last 2.5 centuries of the Industrial Revolution, it was really the United States that was the ultimate beneficiary, the ultimate heir of the Industrial Revolution. And the story of Asia in the last 2 centuries was that Asia missed the Industrial Revolution. That's why we're all speaking English today. But as we emerge into the 21st century, everyone is now operating on the same technological application stack. Our science and technology is transnational. And in that kind of world, multipolarity, emerging poles, is to be expected. So I see us now as basically reverting back to a more natural historical trajectory of multiple poles, and in particular, Asia and India and China.